can restart our subject, computer network. We can start with transport layer. Actually, transport layer is responsible for process to process delivery. The topics in this video are introduction to protocols, port address, socket address, and the need for multiplexing and demultiplexing in transport layer. There are several protocols in transport layer, and it is basically classified into connectionless protocols and connection oriented protocols. Example for a connectionless protocol is UDP, and that of a connection oriented protocol is TCP. If we take the case of connectionless protocol, each segment of the message is delivered or considered as independent packet. Whereas in the case of connection oriented protocol, the transport layer makes a virtual connection from the source port or the source machine to the destination machine, and through that path the segments are delivered, and once all the data is transferred, this connection is terminated. Also, the transport layer performs flow control and error control. As you know, in a network there are possibilities of a fast sender and a slow receiver, which may cause error or data loss. So there must be some provision for handling the situation, which we name as flow control. Also, for the proper communication, some sort of error control must be there. So in effect, the transport layer performs both flow control and error control. The next is the idea of port number. In order to deliver a message, we need the address of the destination, and the transport layer uses the concept of port number as the address. In internet, the port number is a 16-bit integer ranging from 0 to 65,535, and these port numbers are managed by an organization, IANA, Internet Assigned Number Authority. The IANA divides the port numbers into three categories: well-known port numbers, registered port numbers, and dynamic port numbers, as in the figure. When we take the case of well-known ports, the port numbers ranges from 0 to 1023 and is assigned and controlled by IANA. These port numbers are used for certain particular purpose. In other words, they are dedicated for something. Now comes registered ports. These port numbers ranges from 1024 to 49151. The difference is that these are not assigned or not controlled by IANA, but they are to be registered with IANA to prevent the duplication. Now comes the case of dynamic ports. These are the remaining port numbers, that is from 49, 152 to 65, 535. These are neither controlled nor registered with IANA, or these are actually known as ephemeral ports. Actually, ephemeral ports are short-lived transport protocols. These are assigned automatically and they are for temporary purpose only. This means once the need is over, these port numbers are released and can be used by others, or that is by other processes. This figure explains the concept of processes and port numbers. The left side you can see a machine named as bedtime client, and right side a machine named as bedtime server, and we can see three processes, and the middle process is having a port address 52,000 at the client side, and correspondingly a process is having a port address 13 at the receiving side. So as given in the figure, the data segment must carry the data portion and two port addresses. One port address is that of the source and the other port address is that of the destination. And this figure explains IP addresses and port number, the need for IP addresses and port numbers. A node in a network is normally identified using its IP address, and in the figure it is given as the IP address is given as 193.14.26.7, and the node means it is enclosed in the dotted lines, and simply we can identify a node with the IP address only. And the port number is given as 13, which is actually internal identification by the transport layer. So it is given at the bottom that the transport header consists of the port number 13 and the IP header consists of the IP address 193.14.26.7. So for transport layer communication, the identification is by using both IP address and the port address. So such a combination of IP address and the port address is called the socket data. So we define the client process uniquely by using the client socket address, and server process uniquely by using the server socket address. So here we are not identifying the machine, that is source machine and destination machine, or the client machine and the server machine. We are actually identifying the client process and the server process using the socket address. So it is given in the figure that this combination of IP at the port number 69 gives the socket address. Next comes the what need for multiplexing, demultiplexing in transport layer. So at the sending side we need a multiplexer, and the receiving side we need a demultiplexer. So multiplexing. So in the above figure, at the sending side, there are actually four processes, and these four processes may want to communicate with some processes on another machine, but there is only one transport layer protocol. So this single transport layer protocol has to receive all the messages from these different processes, and they are differentiated or they are identified by using their assigned port numbers. The transport layer will add this assigned port numbers to the header and will pass it to the network layer. Actually, it is a network layer who adds the IP address to that datagram. So now that message consists of data, port number and IP address when it pass or when it go from the network layer. Similarly, at the receiver side, the relationship is one to many. That is, the transport layer receives datagrams from the network layer and it has to communicate it with the different processes. That is, this receiving a single message receiving from a network layer, and it is to be divided according to the port address. So the transport layer receives datagrams from the network layer, so performs error checking, and the header is dropped, transport layer header is dropped, and after that delivers the message to the appropriate process based on the port number. So we need multiplexing as well as demultiplexing. The figure shows the position of transport layer protocols UDP, TCP and SCTP in the TCP IP protocol suite. And these protocols will be explained in detail in the next sessions. Okay, for the time being, thank you.